ओम श्री साई राम। श्री साई सच्चरित रिटन बाय हेमत पंजी एंड ट्रांसलेटेड बाय गुना जी। चैप्टर 40 स्टोरीज ऑफ बाबा। इन दिस चैप्टर वी गिव टू स्टोरीज। फर्स्ट वन इज हाउ बाबा अटेंडेड द उद्यापन सेरेमनी ऑफ मिस्टर बीवी डियोस मदर एट हिज हाउस एट दहानू। Second one is how Baba attended the Shimga dinner party in Hemant Pant's house at Bandra. Blessed is Shri Sai Samartha, who gives instructions in both temporal and spiritual matters to his devotees and makes them happy by enabling them to achieve the goal of their life. Sai, he who when places his hand on their heads, transfers his powers to them and thus destroying the sense of differentiation, makes them attain the unattainable thing. He who embraces the bhaktas who prostrate themselves before him with no sense of duality or difference, he becomes one with the bhaktas as the sea with the rivers when they meet it in the rainy season and gives them his power and position. It follows from this that he who sings the leelas of God's bhaktas is equally or more dear to him than one who sings the leelas of God only. Now to revert to the stories of this chapter. Mrs. Dio's Udyapan ceremony. Mr. B.V. Dio was a Mamaltadar at Dahanu, that is Thana district. His mother had observed 25 or 30 different vows and a Udyapan, that is concluding ceremony, in connection therewith was to be performed. This ceremony included the feed of 100 or 200 Brahmins. Mr. Dio fixed a date for the ceremony and wrote a letter to Bapu Sahib Jog asking him to request Sai Baba on his behalf to attend the dinner of the ceremony, as without his attendance the ceremony would not be duly completed. Bapu Sahib Jog read out the letter to Baba. Baba noted carefully the pure-hearted invitation and said, "Always, always think of him who remembers me. I require no conveyance, carriage, tonga, nor train, nor aeroplane. I run and manifest myself to him who lovingly calls me. Write to him a pleasing reply that three of us, that is the trio, myself, yourself and the third, will go and attend it." Mr. Jog informed Mr. Dio of what Baba said. The latter was much pleased, but he knew that Baba never went to any place except Rahata, Rui and Nimgaon in person. He also thought that nothing was impossible to Baba, as he was all-pervading, and that he might suddenly come in any form he likes and fulfill his words. A few days before this, a sannyasi with Bengali dress and professing to work for the cause of the protection of the cows came to the station master at Dahanu to collect subscriptions. The latter told him to go into the town and see the Mamaltadar, that is Mr. Dio, and with his help collect funds. Just then the Mamaltadar happened to come there. The station master then introduced the sannyasi to him. Both sat talking on the platform. Mr. Dio told him that a subscription list for some other charitable cause had already been opened by the leading citizen, Rao Saheb Narottam Shetty, and so it was not good to start another subscription list, and that it would be better if he would visit the place after 2 or 4 months. He Hearing this, the sannyasi left the place. About a month afterwards, the sannyasi came in a tanga and stopped in front of Mr. Dio's house at about 10 a.m. Dio thought that he came for subscriptions. Seeing him busy with the preparations of the ceremony, the sannyasi said that he had come not for money but for meals. Dio said, very glad. You are welcome. The house is yours. The sannyasi, lads are with me. Dio, come with them. As there was time, that is 2 hours for dinner, Dio inquired where he should send for them. He said that it was not necessary as he would come himself at the appointed time. Dio asked him to come at noon. Exactly at 12 noon, the trio came and joined the dinner party and after feeding themselves went away. After the ceremony was finished, Dio wrote a letter to Bapu Sahib Jog complaining of Baba's breach of promise. Jog went to Baba with the letter, but before it was opened, Baba spoke. He says that I promised him to come but deceived him. Inform him that I did attend his dinner with 2 others, but he failed to recognize me. Then why did he call me at all? Tell him that he thought that the sannyasi came to ask for subscription money. Did I not remove his doubt in that respect? And did I not say that I would come with 2 others? And did not the trio come in time and take their meals? See, to keep my words, I would sacrifice my life. I would never be untrue to my words. This reply gladdened Jog's heart and he communicated the whole of the reply to Dio. As soon as he read it, he burst into tears of joy, but he took himself to task mentally for vainly blaming Baba. He wondered how he was deceived by the sannyasi's prior visit and his coming to him for subscriptions. How he also failed to catch the significance of the sannyasi's words that he would come with 2 others for meals. This story clearly shows that when the devotees surrender themselves completely to their Sadguru, he sees that the religious functions in their houses are duly executed and complied with all the necessary formalities. Hemad Pant's Shimga Dinner. Now let us take another story which shows how Baba appeared in the form of his picture and fulfilled the desire of his devotee. In 1917, on the full moon morning, Hemad Pant had a vision. Baba appeared to him in his dream in the form of a well-dressed sannyasi, woke him up and said that he would come to him for meals that day. This awakening constituted a part of the dream. When he fully awoke, he saw no sahi nor any sannyasi. But when he began to recollect the dream, he remembered each and every word the sannyasi uttered in his dream. Though he was in contact with Baba for 7 years, and though he always meditated on Baba, he never expected that Baba would come to his house for meals. However, being much pleased with Baba's words, he went to his wife and informed her that, being the holy day, a sannyasi guest was coming for meals and that some more rice should be prepared. She inquired about the guest, who he was and whence he was coming. Then, not to lead her astray and not to cause any misunderstanding, he gave her the truth, that is, told her about the dream. She doubtingly asked whether it was possible that Baba should come there, that is, Bandra, from Shirdi. leaving the dainty dishes, therefore accepting their coarse food. Hemant Pandit then assured her that Baba might not come in person, but he might attend in the form of a guest, and that they would lose nothing if they cooked some more rice. After these preparations for the dinner went on, and it was quite ready at noon. The Holika worship was gone through, and the leaves or the dishes were spread and arranged with rangoli marks around them. Two rows were put up with a central seat between them for the guest. All the members of the family, sons, grandsons, daughters and sons-in-law, etc., came and occupied their proper seats, and the serving of the various articles commenced. While this was being done, everybody was watching for the guest, but none turned up, though it was past noon. Then the door was closed and chained. The Anna Shuddhi, that is ghee, was served. This was a signal to start eating. Formal offering to the Vaishvadeva, that is fire, and Naivedya to Shri Krishna were also over, and the members were about to begin when footsteps in the staircase were distinctly heard. Hemant Pandit went immediately and opened the door and saw two men there. First one, Ali Muhammad, and second one, Maulana Ismu Muzawar. These two persons, seeing that meals were ready and all the members were about to begin eating, apologized to Hemant Pandit and requested him to excuse their interference. They said, left your seat and came running to us. Others are waiting for you. So please take this your thing, and I shall relate all the wonderful tale about it later on at your convenience. So saying, he took out from his armpit a packet wrapped in an old newspaper cover and placed it on the table. Hemant Pandit uncovered the packet and saw, to his great wonder and surprise, a big nice picture of Sai Baba. Seeing it, he was much moved. Tears ran from his eyes and hair stood on end all over his body, and he bent and placed his head on the feet of Baba in the picture. He thought that Baba had blessed him by this miracle and Leela. Out of curiosity, he asked Ali Muhammad whence he got this picture. He said that he brought it from a shop and that he would give all the details about it sometime afterwards, and wished that as all the members were waiting for him, he should go and join them. Hemant Pandit thanked him, bade them goodbye, and returned to the dining hall. The picture was placed on the central seat reserved for the guest, and after the due offering of the Naivedya, the whole party commenced eating and finished it in proper time. Seeing the beautiful form in the picture, everybody was extremely pleased and wondered how all this happened. This is how Sai Baba kept up and fulfilled his words uttered by him in the dream of Hemant Pandit. The story of the picture with all its details, that is how Ali Muhammad got it, why he bought it and gave it to Hemant Pandit, is reserved for the next chapter. Bo to Shri Sai, peace be to all. Om Shri Sai Ram.